Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to some coverage of NHL Supercard. Now, I brought you a video of my trip out to 2K. They flew us out to check out NHL Supercard early. We got to play a near final build. Well, since we've gotten back, the game is actually released. We've got the final versions on iOS and Android. I play on iOS on the iPhone and iPad. Started off on the iPad here, getting my actual team under my username, not as fan, get my actual starter team here. So we're starting over. What I showed you before was demoing out the game, obviously, for the near final build. But now I want to get my own team started, and I figured you guys could follow along as we try to build this thing up. So we go through the starter pack, which obviously is not going to give us a whole lot. You get one rare player of the team of your choice, I believe, which mine was Matthew Dumba of the Minnesota Wild. And as you see these come through here, yeah, lots of commons, lots of things that are going to be discarded really early on in Supercard here. So if you're not familiar with NHL Supercard, it's basically a free-to-play game on your phone or on your tablet. You collect a group of cards, you put a lineup out, and you take on other teams there in all the different categories there: focus, playmaking, stick handling, and skating. And if they line up and you've got the better scores, you win. And so you want to obviously build up your best deck. So if any of you played WWE Supercard, or if you've played the NBA version, then you basically get the premise and you know how this works. So we're just about through with our starter deck. You see the support cards as well. That'll help boost specific attributes when you take on another team there, either boost your score or penalizes the other one. So there we go. Okay, we've got our starter cards. Matthew Dumba, our best player at rare. This is soon going to change once we play through some games. Now, you see I played a couple here, but I'll just play through one to show you exactly how this works. If you didn't see the first video, then you may not know. Otherwise, yep, here we go. So we're taking on Brady, I guess, in this first wave here. So you want to take your player with the best focus here in this round, because that's what it's asking for. And Dumba is going to come out a winner in that first period. Obviously, you want to win all three periods if you can. You got to win two out of three to win your matchup. But the nice thing about winning all three periods, and that started with this game and it's now carried over to the WWE Supercard as well with the update, is that if you win all three periods, if you sweep it basically, you get to pick an extra card at the end. You normally pick two for a win, but for a sweep, now you see I'm not going to sweep this one because I lost that second round, but for a sweep, you are going to get three cards instead of two, which is kind of nice. You can build up your deck faster and get through all those pulls faster. So here we go with the third period. Hopefully we can win this. Yeah, we do. Okay, so we win the game 5-3. The final scores, those are all just arbitrary. It just adds whatever on for winning the period. Basically, if you win two periods, you're going to win the game. That's the bottom line. That's all you really need to know to play this game. So, okay, after you win a game, you get to choose here. If you lose a game, you get to choose one card. If you win, you get two. If you sweep, you get to choose three of these cards. So you see this is a support card that can be used. We're also going to look for player cards. Oh, we pull another rare here, Matt Calvert. Okay, so he's a left wing. He may fit into my, well, he should fit into my lineup and improve me a little bit here. So we're jumping around, just showing you various highlights here. Now, here's a good pull, super rare. That's my first super rare. It's going to be Dwight King. So he is for sure going into the lineup at left wing right there and is going to be my best player by far in my deck at this point. So like I said, this is a culmination of like a weekend's worth of playing this because they did have a Rivals clash, which we'll get to in a minute. But you want to train your cards up. You can make them higher in attribute here. As you see, that bar fills up, I think, for King. What does he go up to, 25? Yeah, so he's at 8 of 25. And you see how his levels have increased there by recycling other players that you're not going to use. Your commons, your uncommons, even rares that are lesser cards than that you want to recycle in there. And you can also pro cards, which we'll talk about in a while here, which is basically taking two of the same card, maxing them out, and then combining them to make a better version of that card. JT Brown is a rare, and he's a right wing, and I can definitely use that in my lineup. So, okay. Now at this point, we're going to jump into Rivals Clash because that's what was going on over the weekend. And you basically pick a side. You either pick Chicago or pick LA. The next time around they'll do this, they'll pick other teams. Here's the rewards now. If you rank within these certain rankings, you see the rewards that you'll get. Now, There aren't as many people playing this as like the NBA Supercard or the WWE right now. So it's realistic for me to shoot to like this 10,000, actually the under 10,000 range is what I'm looking for. I want two of these Corey Crawfords because then you can pro them, you know, max them out and pro them and put them together. So if you're looking at why my screen went kind of weird there for my template, I switched from the tablet to my phone. And I guess the output's a little bit different. It's not quite as wide. So sorry about the black bars there, but you're going to have to deal with it for the rest of the episode since I did move to my iPhone over the weekend. So we are in Rivals Clash. It's just like playing exhibition games, only they count for the team you picked for. So whatever team gets more wins in the end, whether it's LA or Chicago in this scenario, I'm playing for LA. I don't know. I don't even remember picking that. I thought I would have picked Chicago, but whatever. I ended up on LA's side. So whatever side wins, those are the rewards that are going to pay out. You'll win either way if you're within those parameters for ranking. But you'll just win either the LA rewards or the Chicago rewards, depending on who comes out victorious. So you see we're playing through a round here where I've won the first two periods. And did I get the third? Yeah, okay, there's a sweep. So because I got the sweep, I'll get to pick three cards now. So we'll go on to do that. But I also want to show you how this breaks down. You win for your team. You see plus one win, and you see how many wins collectively LA has. That was a three-point game. You can play either a 1, 3, or 5-point game, and they get harder. So I would stick to mainly three-point games as I was playing through this weekend. And your opponents all kind of fluctuate depending on your level, too. They don't ever put you against somebody who's, like, you know, three tiers ahead of you. But still, if you're playing plus five games, expect tougher games. So we're doing our pulls here, and we get a rare defenseman. Okay, so my defense has kind of been lagging behind, so I don't have any super rares back there or anything. I actually only have the one super rare so far. So we'll definitely play him in our defense at some point here. You see another plus three win. So that ranking, what I'm aiming for here as the weekend rolls on at this point when I was playing it, is getting under 10,000 and staying there because I want those two. I'm assuming Corey Crawford because Chicago is winning the matchups right now. It'll be two Corey Crawfords, or it could be two Jonathan Quicks. But I want those ultra rare pairs that I can eventually level up and train and then pro the two to make a really nice goaltender card. Now, goaltenders in NHL Supercard are a lot like the Divas in WWE Supercard. They're kind of stuck in the one slot. You can't obviously play them in a center or a forward or a defensive spot. They only go in that one goalie slot. So it makes them a little more, I want to say difficult. Ooh, there's another super rare pull. Yuri Hudler. Okay, so that's going to really help out. He's a center. And so we got two super rares now to plug into the mix. So we're definitely going to do that. And then as I was talking about proing cards, okay, this is just a common card, but I have two of them and I maxed them both out because this is the struggle. I don't have a good goaltender right now. I don't have a rare goaltender. So I put these two together, and he is now pro'd, and I can also train him from there. So we'll get him to the point of maybe a rare until we pull a rare goalie. But that's the struggle. I think that is where the most potential to be held back is, because you can pull a super rare at a winger and put him at center or vice versa, or you can put him at D and really not be too penalized, but you know, a goalie only fits in the goalie slot, so you got to wait to pull one of those to put it in there. So we're at 13,000 rank now. We still got to go down a little farther. There we pulled Jonathan Bernier, rare goaltender. So there we go. He automatically is going to be better than what we already had in there. We train him up a little bit and he'll be ready to go. He'll go right into my lineup. So there, as the hunt of the weekend is getting a much better goaltender, but now we've got means to maybe do that, because we at least have a rare back there. So we're going through still here, Rivals Clash. How are we getting here in rank? Let's find out. We are so close. 10,300. Okay. Not only have to get there, but you have to stay there too. People are also frantically trying to get to levels to get different cards. And with that 10,000 being the cutoff, there'll be a lot of people shooting for that. So I win this one. Was not a sweep, but I get it 4-3, meaning I won two periods. And let's see what I pull in this round here. Get the plus three win and we'll get two cards. No, nothing special there, but we are getting closer. We're getting closer to the number. Okay, see, I've ranked down to 9,000, so I'm there right now. If I can hold there, I'll get the cards I want. And as this is over, I also pulled Patrick Hornquist, super rare. So I've got super rares all up front now, center, left wing, right wing. And as this is now over, let's see what I got. 8,958. Yes, I'm in the spot I want to be. So let's go claim our rewards and check this out. Make sure, double check what we got. Yes, we got the two Corey Crawford ultra rares. So we're definitely getting the biggest upgrade on our team by far, even just putting one of these in the lineup until we can max them out and pro them together. So this is why you really want to pay attention to these Rivals Clash things they'll do over weekends or over a week's time, because you can really upgrade your team if you find a slot that you're really needing, say goaltender, you know, whatever the position may be, you can gun for those specific cards. That's going to do it for this episode. Come on back for more NHL Supercard. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!